Hello, today we shall see fiber transport to the rotor. Once the fibers are opened out by the opening roller in the rotor spinning machine, how it is transported to the next part or the what is the next passage, and for that we need to see the fiber transport. So after opening the fibers, it must be supplied to the rotor. The guidance is provided by a closed fiber channel. The centrifugal force of the opening roller and together with the vacuum in the rotor housing, both these factors cause the fibers to disengage from the opening roller and pass towards the rotor through the fiber channel. Transport of the fibers is affected by the air current generated by the suction of air from the sealed rotor housing. We have seen earlier that the spin box or the rotor housing is completely airtight, sealed, and there is a suction applied over there. Because of this air current which is generated, the transport of the fibers is happening because of this particular air current that gets generated here. Vacuum is generated by perforated rotors, and it depends on the rotor size as well as the speed of the rotor. The partial spinning vacuum, it goes on reducing as the rotor diameter becomes smaller, or if there is some amount of dirt or dust that accumulates in the openings in the base of the rotor. Both these factors lead to a declining spinning vacuum. So let us see how the fiber guide channel looks like. This is the photograph of the guide channel. And the shape of the fiber guide channel is very crucial for the fiber transport and also for the orientation, the longitudinal orientation of the fibers, which is very much desirable in case of rotor spinning. The fiber channel narrows towards the rotor, and this narrowing of the fiber channel causes the acceleration of the air and the fiber that flows towards the rotor. The acceleration is very important because as it helps in the separation of the fibers and also it straightens the fibers. So at this place, this is the place where we talked about the second draft that is applied, and the fibers that are fed to the rotor are around 1 to 5 fibers at a time, which then slide down the rotor wall and they form the fiber ring. The narrowing region therefore here represents a second draft, and the first one was the feed roller and the opening roller zone. So let us come to the fiber deposition in the rotor groove. After the fibers exit the fiber channel, they are guided directly on the rotor wall for deposition in the rotor groove. The air together with the remaining dust flows over the rotor rim to the central filter housing. Whatever air is being sucked out, remaining air which is coming out of the fiber channel, that air is then just flows over the rotor rim and it goes to the central filter housing. The outlet opening of the fiber guide channel, we must see to it that it is positioned very, very close to the rotor wall so that we see to it that the good fibers are not sucked over the edge. Whatever air is flowing over the edge to the central filter housing, we should see to it that we don't lose good fibers along with that air. So there are interchangeable channel inserts in which the fiber guide channel is integrated, and these are available depending on the given rotor diameter, and they can be used as per whatever diameter we choose to have. If the distance between the fiber guide channel and the rotor wall is outside the optimum range, if it is not perfect, then good fibers can pass uncontrolled into the extraction system. That means along with the air, we may lose even some good fibers, which will result in increased ends down. That means the yarn will break very frequently. And also that we would find a change in yarn count, which leads to huge costs due to defective fabrics that we may produce from such kind of defective yarns. So let us look at what are channel inserts and where are they located. what we saw just now are the different types of inserts that you can have. It was represented by an orange and a green insert, which could be changed depending on the rotor size, or we decide the rotor size and then decide which kind of insert we need to use. So there is one more arrangement in this fiber guide channel, which is known as a speed pass, and it is nothing but an additional opening in the fiber guide channel. And how it helps is some of the amount of fiber transport air is extracted through this opening. That means some of the air enters is extracted through this opening. It'll just be sucked out through this opening, and because of which some more amount of air is allowed to enter the fiber guide channel. We'll shortly see this in a video and this will become more clearer. The increased air volume promotes whatever extra air that is coming in through this speed pass, via the speed pass. It helps in disentangling the fibers from the opening roller clothing. It helps in removing them and guiding them towards the rotor. The feature is beneficial during the processing of man-made fibers and their blends, which have more than 50% of man-made fibers. It is also useful for coarse counts with higher material throughput. That means when you're when you're going to produce coarse counts which requires huge amount of material throughput, in such cases you need to support the fibers in guiding them towards the rotor, and that is the reason why you need this speed pass during that time. Cotton dust and abrasive used in the finishing of man-made fibers are also extracted through this opening, and it does not accumulate in the rotor groove. This will lead to improvements in yarn characteristics. So now let us see how the speed pass looks like. So we have just seen the speed pass, where we have seen an extra additional opening, extra opening over here, and so let us go to the video where we see all the technological developments that we have seen up till now, and I'll just explain wherever required. So yarn formation with these unique technological parts that we have just seen. So first, in our previous lecture, we saw the bypass arrangement. We saw the bypass, how we can adjust this knob and increase or decrease the amount of trash that is coming out through the housing. We can keep it half open or maybe open or closed depending on the amount of trash that is there in our feed material. So then we saw the channel pass or the channel inserts, which is somewhere here. If you remove the opening roller, you see it just above it. This is the entry where the fibers enter, and this insert can be changed. Then we see this speed pass, which is an additional opening in the fiber guide channel. So what you can see is the fibers are entering over here. There's an extra opening in the fiber guide, which extracts the air over here. Therefore, more air is entering this fiber guide, and the fibers are directed accurately into the rotor. So we have seen two more technological developments today. One is the channel inserts and the second is the speed pass. So with this, we come to the end of the lecture. Thank you.